coral reefs are like rainforests of the sea, and like those here on land, they are being destroyed. But why should you care?
In a world of pure imagination, take a look and you'll see into your imagination.
What are coral reefs? Coral aren't just colorful rocks, but tiny living things live in there. Those rocks are actually the skeletons of polyps. Polyps constantly secrete calcium carbonate to build this protective skeleton. This is why people say coral reefs are living, not because the calcium structures are alive, but because the polyps live inside those structures. They have inside the tissues small plants, these microalgae, the plants that live inside them, photosynthesis, and the animal uses that for their foods. They essentially have food factories living inside of themselves.
Important of coral, you probably grew up hearing the reefs were important, but never sure why. Thousands of species can be found living on one coral reef. For example, the Great Barrier Reef contains over 400 species of coral, 1,500 species of fish, 4,000 species of mollusks, and 6 species of turtles. Coral also control how much carbon dioxide is in the ocean. They take carbon dioxide out of the water and use it to build their calcium carbonate skeletons. Without coral, the amount of CO2 in the water will affect the whole planet. If that wasn't enough, the ridges in coral reefs can reduce wave energy by up to 95%, providing crucial protection from threats such as tsunami or cyclone, and they are better than the ones that we can produce because they are growing and rebuilding it all the time.
Today, coral are in trouble. It is up to us to do all we can to stop the threats that are endangering them. One of the many threats to coral reef is overfishing, which is a problem because fish help reefs survive by eating the algae that can overgrow and smother the corals. This is due to harmful algae blooms that can occur and makes the water cloudy. This will block the sunlight, preventing corals' algae from growing food for itself. But the major threats that are threatening the coral reefs are global warming. A lot of people don't realize climate change is happening because most of the extra heat trapped by greenhouse gases has been transferred to the ocean. What people don't know is that 93% of heat that's trapped is absorbed by the ocean. That's a lot of energy. Coral reefs are very sensitive to temperature change and cannot survive at a temperature that are too warm or a spike of 1 to 2 degrees Celsius than the normal temperature. This will lead to the event of coral bleaching. Coral bleaching itself is a response of stress and coral starts to bleach. When a coral bleaches and dies, it will lose the coral animals. But a coral is a fundamental part of a huge ecosystem. It's easy to think about the fate of an individual species, but it's the beginning of an ecological collapse of the entire ecosystem. It's more than the species, the genus, the family, the order. We are talking about the possibilities that the entire classes of organisms would go extinct.
The world's oceans are so big, we thought for a long time that there was nothing humans could do to hurt them. Now, we are facing an imminent and global collapse. Coral reef fish are a significant food source for over 1 billion people worldwide. Many coastal and island communities depend on coral reef fisheries for their economic, social, and cultural benefits. Hence, you should educate yourself on local fishing rules and regulations. Your state fishery agency or bait and tackle shop can help you to learn more and only take what you need and only catch and release fish that you don't plan to eat. Climate change is the greatest global threat to coral reef ecosystems. Scientific evidence now clearly indicates that the Earth's atmosphere and ocean are warming, and that these changes are primarily due to greenhouse gases derived from human activities. Shrink your carbon footprint to reduce greenhouse gases by drive less or carpooling, reduce, reuse, and recycle, purchase energy-efficient appliances and light bulbs, print less, download more to reduce paper usage, and use less water. Spread the word. Learn more about coral reefs and educate your community. You can share this information with your family, your friends, your local schools and businesses. and you can always contact your local representatives to see what your state is doing to protect water quality and coral reefs.
Coral reefs are hugely important for the ocean because they are essentially the nursery, and 25% of all marine life relies on coral reef. We have got 500 million to 1 billion people that rely on coral reef as their main source of food. Without that protein, they are going to be malnourished. Their culture, their way of life, their economies are all reliant on healthy coral reef. The coral are the real basis of the ecosystem. You can't have a city without the buildings, and you can't have coral reef without the corals. If we can't save this ecosystem, are we gonna have courage to save the next ecosystems down the line? Do we need forests? Do we need trees? Do we need reefs? Or can we just sort of live in the ashes of all that?
Thank you for watching.
Bye!
And you'll see into your imagination.